Anyway, I hope you folks had a nice weekend. And today what we're going to do is we're going to take the combined gas laws. So we have these gas laws. And the gas laws all work assuming that the gases follow these five principles. We call these the ideal principles. And if we follow the ideal principles, then we have this equation that tells us that PV over T equals PV over T. And this would be initial, and then this here would be final. And something that sometimes gets left out is the moles, like that. And anytime something stays constant, such as the moles, then you can cancel it out. So for example, if the temperature doesn't change from initial to final, that you end up with the same numbers there, and so then you can cancel those out. And oftentimes it's the moles, because it's like you have a balloon or something or a car tire. You don't change the number of moles that are in there, the number of molecules. You're really just changing the temperature, the pressure, or the volume. Okay, so that's the equation. That equation works as long as the gases are behaving ideally. Now, there is some mathematical jujitsu that can happen where we can arrange this equation and come up with something a little bit different. PV equals nRT. And in this equation here, we have some units here. We have pressure, which should be measured in atmospheres. And we have volume, which should be in liters. And then here we recognize that. What is N? Moles, number of moles, okay? Moles, and then here we have temperature. Now this gets a little bit tricky. Up to this point, we've been using Celsius instead of Fahrenheit because Fahrenheit is pukey, and it's tough to do math on that. So we've been using Celsius. But now when we get to the gas laws, as you notice here, as the temperature gets smaller, I suppose these things here might get bigger, maybe? Or, well, here's what I'm thinking. What happens if temperature gets to zero? Absolutely. Well, our equation no longer works if we get to zero, because now we have a zero here. I don't know if you remember from math, like, you can't divide by zero, right? That's a no-no. It's where the nun comes and whacks your knuckles on, you know, with a ruler. Maybe you went to a different school than me. But anyway, yeah, you can't divide by zero, so we have to use something different. What can we do besides Fahrenheit and Celsius? Kelvin, yeah. So for temperature, we're going to use Kelvin. So when you're working on these worksheets and such, make sure to convert to Kelvins. Now, Kelvin, to do that, a Kelvin is equal to degrees Celsius plus 273. And just a little tidbit for you here, if you ever want to sound super smart and stuff like that, never ever say degrees Kelvin. Yeah, I know, it's funny, right? Because you never use degrees Kelvin. And the reason for that is because Kelvin is an absolute scale. It starts at absolute zero, and it's pedantic, and it's one of those esoteric sorts of things. But because Celsius is arbitrary, you use degrees, and Kelvin is not arbitrary, and so you don't use degrees. And you could probably go your entire life and never know or care. But if you're with a bunch of science people, and then you say degrees Kelvin, they'll be like, idiot, right? Imbecile, doesn't know that there's no such thing as degrees Kelvin. Okay, so now you're all in on the joke. All right. So that's the conversion there. And then the last thing here that we haven't talked about is this thing called R. And R is a gas constant. It's a universal gas constant. So if we were to take this equation and solve for R, our units on that would be liter atmospheres over mole Kelvin, mole Kelvin. And the number on this is 0.08206 is the constant. Liter atmospheres, mole Kelvin. And put a star next to that, because that's one of those things that comes up again and again. Now, you don't need to memorize it. I would give it to you perhaps on a test, but you got to know what to do with it. And that's the value of R. It's a gas constant. And there's different ways of measuring this depending on whether or not you're using pascals. The rest of the world uses pascals, so that would be the R value up there. But we in the United States like to think of ourselves as special. And so we just like, what, the rest of the world does that? Well, heck no, we're going to do it this way, right? And so we use a different value for R. All right. Any questions on any of that? Okay. Now, why would we use this new equation? Well, if somebody gave you a certain amount of gas measured in grams, well, you can take grams of a gas and convert it into moles. And once you convert it into moles, you could figure out then, if you knew maybe the temperature and the pressure, what the volume is. So somebody says, hey, if I have 10 grams of nitrogen, how much volume does it take up at room temperature and pressure? Well, you just plug in the numbers and then solve for the volume. So that's kind of slick. That works out pretty slick. And so there's a few questions on the worksheet like that that you would need to use this equation. And then there's something a little tricky on there as well, and that is some of those gases are diatomic. Yeah, so when, as you look at it and you think, oh, diatomic, things like hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, chlorine, fluorine, iodine, those are all diatomic gases. So something to just kind of keep in the back of our mind, are these diatomic?